So welcome to a question and answer session for interested master students. My name is Martina Dalla-Almander. I work at the faculty office here at the Faculty of Science at the University of Gothenburg. I'm originally from Germany and I also did my master's in Sweden and I've been here pretty much ever since. We here at the faculty, we have 7 departments within the natural sciences and 20 programs that are master programs that are conducted in English. And we have 3 departments represented here with us today. So I would like to introduce our students here today. Maybe Kosala, you can start.
Yeah, hi all. My name is Kosala, so I'm from Sri Lanka. I studied my master's in chemistry.
Bryn, you?
Yeah, my name is Bryn. I'm from the United States, from California, and I'm studying for a master's in environmental science.
Hey, I'm Alana, and I'm from Vancouver, Canada. I'm studying a master's in sea and society.
Yes. So why don't you tell us why you chose to study at the University of Gothenburg? Maybe Bryn, you can start.
Yeah, I knew I wanted to go to graduate school, but kind of wanted something different than what I had gotten in my undergraduate degree in California. And looking for environmental programs all throughout Europe, Sweden seemed to have a lot. And the program at University of Gothenburg seemed to fit in with what I wanted to do, a more general program. And yeah, I'm excited to be here.
Alana, why did you come here?
Yeah, I'm similar to Bryn in that I found as I was looking through different types of programs, the University of Gothenburg seemed to really stand out on the sustainability scale. And I'm really interested in sustainability. And that's kind of the avenue I want to go into with a focus on ocean sustainability. And the Sea and Society program, I thought really stood out for that.
Mm-hmm. Kosala?
Yeah, for me, after completing my bachelor's degree in Sri Lanka, I want to continue my studies in the field of computational chemistry. So I was pleased to come across a wide range of computational chemistry research done by many research groups with exciting research topics, and they have many collaboration between the outside partners as well in Gothenburg University. So I mainly chose Gothenburg University because of the research work done by the Department of Chemistry and Molecular Biology.
Cool.
You can go to the university website first to look at the programs that are available. And once you find the one that you're interested in, you can click on the link that will take you to universityadmissions.se. And then you can apply and submit all your documents through there. And that's for any university in Sweden.
And how long are the master's programs here at the university, or at least at the Faculty of Science?
They're all 2-year programs.
Yes. Bryn, can you tell us a little bit about how you thought the application process was on university admissions?
Yeah, it was a lot different than anything I had experienced before, in that you submit all your applications and all your documents on that one site, and you can only apply to 4 different programs. And you want to make sure to prioritize your 4 programs, so to have your first choice listed first, because if you get admitted into that program, you get deleted from all the other ones. So you want to make sure that the one you have listed first is actually your first choice. And then if you don't get into that one, it'll just go down the list until you get into one on your list.
That's a good tip to remember. And what about application deadlines?
Yeah, the applications are due January 15th.
Okay, and that's a general deadline, right?
Yes.
Okay, And then, so once you've submitted your application, you also have to apply for a residence permit in Sweden. So how, Kosala, how was that process for you?
For the non-EU citizens, for applying a student visa in Sweden is a pretty straightforward and simple process. So I will go through my experience. First, I fill the visa application form and submit the required document online in migration agency website. Then I got my decision within 2 to 3 weeks. And I went to the Swedish embassy and gave my biometrics, that means fingerprint, photos. And then I collect my visa from Sweden consulate office in Sri Lanka.
Sounds pretty straightforward, yeah?
Yes.
Yep. So if we go back to how studies are organized in Sweden, Alana, how do you get in contact with the right persons at the departments or for your program? How does that work?
Yeah, so each faculty in each department has a list on the website. And if you go to the program that you're interested in on the website there, there's the contact person's name, phone number, and email.
How do you find housing in Gothenburg? How did you do that?
Yeah, initially I didn't get a university student apartment, so I need to apply through the private websites called Blocket. So luckily I got 3 offers and I select the student room at the Swedish family house. And then after 4 to 5 months, I got a student apartment near the university.
Okay. And Alana, how did it work for you?
For me, I posted an ad of my own on Blocket. Mm-hmm. So it cost me 120 kroners to post an ad. So I just included a picture of myself and a little bit about me and posted it in the group that is looking for housing. And I was able to find a place through there. I also joined groups on Facebook. There's, I think it's called International Student Gothenburg Housing or something along those lines. So you can definitely search for Facebook groups that rent out rooms, and often you can find people like other students who are also looking for roommates to share eligibility as well.
Yeah, so definitely being proactive is a good tip here as well.
Yeah.
You're all fee-paying students, so how does it work with the scholarships? Are there scholarships available at all, Kosala? Yeah,
the main scholarship is Axel Olders scholarship, and you can apply before you start your master's. And also while you're studying, you can apply for several scholarships. For example, I applied for Alberta scholarship and Alberta Foreign Student Hospitality Foundation, and also donation board scholarship. These scholarships are available throughout the year.
Yeah, and then there might be study in Sweden or the Swedish Institute. They have scholarships, I know, as well. And I'm sure maybe your home country even has scholarships that you could look up. Anybody else have any tips on that? Or
I have a tip about the scholarship from the University of Gothenburg. When I applied, I got an email like saying that my application had gone through, and then a link to an application for a scholarship that was basically full ride. But I didn't look at it then because I figured that why would I apply to a scholarship before I know if I've been accepted to the program? And unfortunately, the scholarship application deadline is in February, and you don't find out until April. So if you are interested, just apply anyways.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely, because you can always say no thank you afterwards. What do classes look like for you guys? Do you have a lot of lab work? You're all in different programs. Do you have a lot of field trips? Or what does a normal school day look like for you? And obviously, two of you started in fall 2019 when everything was still normal. So if you compare a little bit how it was then to now. Maybe Kosala, you can...
For the chemistry masters, there are about 10 to 20 students in the class. Normally lectures are 1 to 2 hours a day in the morning session. And afternoon, we have laboratory courses. The duration is 3 to 4 hours. And each course has group projects and group presentation as well. Actually, I really enjoy the lab work. And comparing the situation right now, because of the COVID, all the classes are online, but you can continue your research project. You can go to the lab. For example, for myself, in my research group, we are divided into two and minimize the number of students in the lab. So the good news is I can still continue my research without any interruptions.
Yeah. And Alana, what is a normal school day for you, pre-COVID maybe?
Yeah, so last year, during the first year of the CN Society program, everybody in that program was taking the same courses. So usually our day started at 10 a.m. We'd have a 2-hour lecture, lunch break, and then we'd go back to class to meet with our classmates and do a discussion on what basically we had talked about in the morning, which I really liked how there was kind of the learning part, but then also the chance to discuss it with your classmates and kind of bounce ideas off of each other. And we had a little bit of like project work. Sometimes once a week we would have projects. And we did have a couple field trips up to Sharna Marine Laboratory and Christina Bay Marine Laboratory, which are really, really great facilities.
Yeah, that we have campuses a little bit all over. So that's good that you mentioned that we have marine stations on the coast, and that's a little bit one of a kind, I would say. So yeah, you get to see not only Gothenburg, but some other parts of the country as well if you study here. If we talk about studying and COVID-19, we can say it's hard to predict what the future will bring, but we're kind of planning for somewhat a hybrid version for the spring semester as well. So some online classes and some parts of the classes will be, or classes, lab work, field work, and things like that will be conducted on campus, especially for international master students. So we'll see what the fall of 2021 will look like, but the plan is to slowly go back to more on-campus based education. Talking about the city of Gothenburg, do you think it's easy to get around the city? Bryn, what do you say?
Yeah, I've only been here for about 3 months and I've already found that it's a really fun city to explore, and the trams take you everywhere you could possibly want to go, and the buses also. Where I live, I walk about 1 minute to the tram stop, and in 15 minutes, I'm at Central Station. So it's super easy to get around. There's an app where you can buy tickets, and then also on that app, it shows you what time the tram is coming, and everything. And then also walking around is super easy. There's tons of coffee shops and restaurants and everything you could imagine within walking distance of downtown. So it's been great so far, and I find it super easy to get around.
Mm-hmm. What about you guys? You've been here for a little bit longer. Any Have you tried any of those ferries that take you to the islands outside of Gothenburg or something like that?
Yeah, I've been to a couple of the islands, and again, it's super easy. The ferries are included in the Västtrafik, so you can just get on a ferry and then it takes you down, and you can go to the southern archipelago and the northern archipelago. Mm-hmm. They're super beautiful, especially in the summer.
I think in Sweden it's pretty easy to get around. I usually go around by bicycle. So for me, coming to the university or going around, it's pretty easy by bicycle. And also buses and tram as well.
Yeah, Gothenburg tries to be bicycle friendly.
Yeah.
Bryn, you mentioned that you take Swedish classes, right?
Yeah, I'm in the university's entry level Swedish class right now. That's, I think, 10 courses long. So I'm just about halfway through that. And it's been great. That's on Zoom, so it's a little difficult to learn a language online, but it helps to go out and about in the city and try to read the signs and menus and things like that, just to get a little more exposure.
Do you have any favorite words in Swedish?
Oh, man. I don't think so. Not yet. I'm still working on it, but a real favorite activity and also Swedish word of mine is fika. So I've learned to love fika, and that's a great word also.
And that means just taking a cup of coffee or tea or something sweet and just sitting at a, it doesn't even have to be at a cafe, it just can be sit down with a friend and have a chat. And that everybody says, even if you're not Swedish speaking, everybody that's been here knows what fika means. If you look at my background, that actually I chose that today because it actually snowed where I live, a little bit outside of Gothenburg. But how do you find the weather to be in general in Gothenburg, and maybe especially in wintertime? Summers are beautiful, I think. But with the stereotype of Swedish winter is that it's dark and not so nice. What do you think, guys?
It's actually fairly similar to Vancouver, so it wasn't a super shock for me, but it definitely is fairly wet, so you want to have some good gear. But yeah, it's not so bad. You just have fika when it gets dark, meet with friends when it's COVID safe. There, especially right now in the Christmas season, there's loads of Christmas lights up. So it's actually really nice. So it doesn't feel so terrible.
Yeah. Kosala, how about you, coming from a warmer climate? What do you say?
For me, the winter is somewhat dark, but I expect getting worse and worse, but now it's okay for me. And temperature is around -1, -2, but the average is Celsius 5, so I think it's okay for me. But I get D vitamin for me, yeah.
Yes, that's a good one. Yeah, I was really good at that the first couple of years I was living in Sweden. Now I'm not so good anymore, but that was a good reminder, yeah. Bryn, do you have anything to say about the weather in Sweden?
Yeah, I think the darkness for me was a bit of a shock. I knew it was going to be dark, but it doesn't really get light even when it's daylight. It's kind of always gray. So that was a bit surprising for me, but I find ways to make it work. I have coffee and tea in the middle of the day and go for walks when it's light out, and it's been okay so far. This is my first Swedish winter, but it hasn't been too bad.
No.
Making it work.
Then I would like to thank you very much, Bryn, Alana, and Kosala, for being here with me today and sharing your experiences and your stories. Forever is listening, check out the gu.se website. There will be a link to my contact information. Feel free to contact me and ask questions, and more links about the programs that are available at the Faculty of Science. Thanks for listening, and see you in Gothenburg.
Yeah. Bye. Bye-bye. Nice.